multiple variants of entrepreneurship today, particularly in education. And so there are private sector, for-profit innovations. There are social entrepreneurs. I think all of those have a shared objective of making the world better for people broadly and trying to help millions of people across the globe, in developing countries, in developed countries. And so I think you're seeing a real surge of activity and commitment among some of the most capable, high potential people we could ever imagine, all setting out to try to make it possible for kids everywhere to learn more effectively. Confusion in the area of education about what's innovation and what isn't. And so you see a lot of things that are out there where they take very traditional education methods, put them online in archived videos, and deliver that to students. And a lot of people get excited and think that's innovative. I think that's not. I think that brings cost efficiencies to a model that's largely proven to be a failed model. I think there's some very interesting things going on in the area of peer-to-peer interaction in terms of accessing resources to essentially put the student learning experience at a much higher level than it would be, in terms of connecting a learning experience with a professional or a downstream earning experience. And so there are some profound changes going on that I think are really exciting, but I think that it's important to distinguish between what really delivers a different learning experience that lets kids develop the critical skills they're going to need to be happy and be successful in life versus stuff that just happens to touch or live on a computer.